Hello, my dear students. Today's topic is hyperbolic and inverse hyperbolic functions. And all of you are introduced with these concepts in your regular intermediate classes. But for the sake of easiness, just I will give some of the definitions of these functions and then you will work out problems. Now, we just recall the concepts of the infinite series of e power x and the hyperbolic functions. And we know that e power x is equal to 1 plus x by factorial 1 plus x square by factorial 2 plus x cubed by factorial 3, etc. up to infinity. And e power minus x is equal to 1 minus x by factorial 1 plus x square by factorial 2 minus x cubed by factorial 3 plus etc. up to infinity, where x is real or complex. Now the definition, and also now number one, the sine h x, hyperbolic sine h x is equal to e power x minus e power minus x is by 2, and 2 cos hx is equal to e power x plus e power minus x by 2, and 3 tan hx is e power x sin hx by cos hx, just like our trigonometric functions. That is e power x minus e power minus x by e power x plus e power minus x. And this cosecant inverse, cosecant hx, cos secant hx, and cot hx are reciprocals of the above three functions. Domain and range. See, number one, sine hx, entire real numbers. Range is also entire real numbers. Cos hx or what range is simply 1 to infinity. And tan hx is R, that is real number set, and this is range is my open interval minus 1 plus 1 range. And the next one, cot hx is defined for all real numbers except 0. And range is the entire line, real line, except the closed interval minus 1 plus 1. And secant hx, entire real number R, and the range is 0, open interval 0, left closed 1, and cosecant hx is r minus singleton 0, and here also r minus singleton 0. See, wherever sin hx comes in the denominator, so the domain will be all real numbers except 0. So these are the domain and range of the 6 hyperbolic functions. Now here please note that sin h0 is equal to 0 and cos h0 is equal to 1, tan h0 is equal to 0. And also one more fact I will give you that, and sin hx, tan hx, cot hx, and cosecant hx. Cosecant hx are odd functions. Whereas cos hx and secant hx are even. Are even functions. Right? Now, just for recalling sake, I will give you which can two or three formulae regarding these functions and which can be easily verified by using the definitions. In trigonometry, we know that cos sin square x plus cos square x is equal to 1. But when it comes to the hyperbolic functions, it is cos 2hx. So, some standard formula I will give you that cos h square x minus sin h square x is 1 and 2 cos h square x plus sin h square x is equal to cos h 2x. And also, and that is same as cos h square x plus sin h square x. 3, cos h 2x is equal to 1 plus 2 sin h square x. 1 plus 2 sin h square x. And 4, I will give you that this is sin h 2x is 2 sin hx cos hx. 2 sin hx cos hx. Now, I will give you that tan h2x is tan h2x actually e power 2x minus e power minus 2x by e power 2x plus e power minus 2x. So, right. See, almost all in EMACET examination, all the problems are only one problem you will get. And all are directly by you can solve directly by using the definitions. Number one, if sin hx is equal to 3 by 4, then cos h2x is equal to 1, 7 by 4, 2, 15 by 8, and 3, 5 by 4, and 4, 17 by 18. And cos h2x, just I have written, cos h2x is equal to 1 plus 2 sin h square x. So that is 1 plus 2 into sin h x is 3 by 4. So 9 by 16. 9 by 16, which is 1 plus 9 by 8. So which is equal to 17 by 8. So answer is 4, right? Number 2, I'll give you. If tan hx is equal to 3 by 5, then tan h 3x is equal to number 1, 61 by 63, number 2, 63 by 61, number 3, 65 by 63, 4, 63 by 65, 63 by 65 is, by the formula, you can check it, 3 tan hx plus plus tan h cubed x by 1 plus 3 tan h square x. 3 tan h square x. But in trigonometry functions, circular functions, tan 3x is 3 tan x minus tan cubed x by 1 minus 3 tan square x. Now, this is equal to 3 into, what is tan hx value? You are given 3 by 5. So, 3 by 5 plus 3 by 5 whole cubed by 1 plus 3 into 3 by 5 whole square. So, that is 9 by 5 plus 27 by 125, 27 by 125 whole by 1 plus 27 by 25, 27 by 25. So, if you want to check it, then what you get is 1 plus 3 into 3 means 9 into 3, 27 is okay. So, this is equal to how much you will get? 9 into or 9 into 25 plus 27 into, sorry, plus 27 by 25 plus 27 means 52 into, what you look at is 25 by 125. So now if you simplify it, or all this is necessary, you can simplify it because it's arithmetic. This you will get, that is what you get is 63 by 65. That is equal to 63 by 65 itself. The remaining, this is the simple arithmetic. I don't do the simplification. You have to do. Okay. So problem number 3 is cos h3 minus sin h3 is equal to 1 e 2 1 by e 3 e cubed and 4 e power minus 3, right? And you know that by definition cos h3 minus sin h3 is equal to e cubed plus e to the power of minus 3 by 2 minus of e cubed minus of e to the power of minus 3 by 2. So, which is 2e^3/2, which is equal to e^-3, which is equal to e^-3. So the answer is, again, get 4. Right, 4. If u is equal to log of to the base e into tan of, this is ordinary trigonometric tan, tan of π/4 plus theta by 2, then cos hu, cos hu is equal to, number one, cos theta, number two, secant theta, three, sin theta, and four, cosecant theta. Cosecant theta. Right. So, solution is u is equal to log of tan π/4 plus θ/2 to the base e implies e^u is equal to tan π/4 plus θ/2. So that is equal to 1 plus tan θ/2 by 1 minus tan θ/2. 1 plus tan θ/2 by 1 minus tan θ/2. So therefore, this is, and so therefore e power minus u is equal to 1 minus tan θ/2, 1 minus tan θ/2 by 1 plus tan θ/2. Because e power minus u means 1 by e power u. 1 by e power u. So this will be reversed. So therefore, cos hu is equal to e power u plus e power minus u by 2. So which is equal to, if you write this one, 1 plus tan θ/2 whole square, if you take this one, plus 1 minus tan θ/2 whole square by 1 minus tan square theta by 1 plus tan θ/2 whole square plus 1 minus tan θ/2 whole square by 1 minus tan square θ/2. But this is, that is equal to 2 into 1 plus tan square θ/2 by 1 minus tan square θ/2. And this is nothing but by 2 e power minus sin hu by 2 into, by 2 into, 2, 2 will cancel. So that is simply secant hu. In the ordinary circular functions, 1 plus tan square θ/2 by 1 minus tan square θ/2 is nothing but secant theta. So the answer is number 2, because you know that cos theta is 1 plus tan square θ/2 by 1 minus tan square θ/2 by 1 plus tan square θ/2. So this is, please remember, I will explain you here. You know that cos 2 theta, just wait a bit, cos square theta minus sin square theta, and that is cos square theta minus sin square theta by cos square theta plus sin square theta. So that is equal to 1 minus tan square theta by 1 plus tan square theta. So that cos theta is 1 minus tan square theta by 2 by 1 plus tan square theta by 2. So here you got 1 plus tan square theta by 2 by 1 minus tan square theta by 2. The reverse. So 1 by cos theta. This is simply 1 by cos theta, which is nothing but secant theta. So the answer is option 2. If sin alpha into cos h beta is equal to cos theta and cos alpha sin h beta is equal to sin theta, then sin h square beta is equal to, number one, sin square alpha, two, cos square alpha, three, sin square beta, and four, cos square beta. Right, solution is, we know that 1 is equal to cos square theta plus sin square theta. So that is equal to sin square alpha cos h square beta plus cos square alpha sin h square beta. Sin square beta. So therefore what you look at is 1 minus, you bring this term to the left hand side, 1 minus sin square alpha cos h square beta is equal to cos square alpha sin h square beta. Cos square alpha sin h square beta. But this cos square alpha you can write as 1 minus sin square alpha into sin h square beta. So if you bring to this side, this is, so therefore 1 plus sin square alpha into sin h square beta minus cos h square beta. Sin square alpha, sin h square beta, you brought to the left hand side, that minus becomes plus. So if you write minus here, sin h square beta, sin square alpha, right, which is equal to cos square alpha sin h square beta. But this is 1 minus sin square alpha, but this is, you know that cos h2 beta. 1 minus, see, cos square, 1 minus sin square alpha into cos h square beta. So this is, okay, 1 minus sin square alpha into cos h square beta is equal to 1 minus sin square alpha into sin square h beta. So if this bring to the side, what you look at is, if you take minus, this will become plus. So you will get here beta is equal to sin square beta. So that means sin square alpha, and you know that inverse hyperbolic functions, this value is 1 into 1 is equal to sin h square beta. So therefore cos square alpha is equal to sin h square beta. So what you are asked, sin h beta is equal to cos alpha. 1 minus sin square alpha means cos alpha. Cos alpha is equal to sin h square beta. So cos square alpha means cos square alpha is equal to sin h square beta means what you get is this one, sin h square beta. We got this cos square alpha is equal to sin h square beta, that's all. So what you are asked is then sin h square beta, right? Sin h square beta, this is the asked, is not. Then sin h square beta. Right, what is the answer? Cos square alpha. If sin hx, if sin hx is equal to cos theta and sin theta is equal to 2 by 3, then cos hx is equal to 1 root 5 by 3 2 5 by 3 3 root 14 by 3 and 4 14 by 3 14 by 3 itself. Okay. So cos hx, and you know that cos square hx minus sin square hx is equal to 1 implies cos h square x or sin h square x. Sin h square x is equal to 1 plus cos h square x. Sin h square is equal to, cos h square x minus 1. Okay. Now, what is sin h square x? Sin h square cos theta. So, that implies cos square theta is equal to cos square hx minus 1. And that is, cos square theta is square root of 1 minus sin square theta, which is equal to cos h square x. So, you can write, because sin theta is equal to square root of 1 minus cos theta square root of 1 minus sin square theta, which is 1 minus, what is sin theta value? You are given 2 by 3 whole square is equal to cos h square x minus 1. So that implies, if you bring to the side, cos h square x is equal to 2 plus 4 by 9, 2 plus 4 by 9, 2 plus 4 by 9. So how much you will get? Cos square hx, sin square hx, cos h square x minus 1 is okay. So that means cos square theta is equal to cos square hx, cos h square x minus 1. So this is 1 minus sin square theta is equal to cos square x minus 1. So, if you take 1 minus 2 by 3 whole square is equal to minus 1. So, cos h square x, if you bring to the side 2 minus, what you get is 4 by 9, 4 by 9, 1 minus 4 by 9. See, this minus 1, if it comes here, 1 plus 1, 2, minus 2 by 3 whole square, 4 by 9, which is equal to 14 by 9. So, this implies that cos hx is equal to root 14 by 3. Cos hx is root 14 by 3. So, the correct answer is option 3. cos hx is equal to 2, then a value of x is 1 log 2 to the base e 2 log 3 to the base e 3 log of 2 plus root 3 to the base e and 4 log of root 2 plus 3 to the base e. Now just to use the definition of cos hx. Now put x is equal to 2 in cos hx definition e power x plus e power minus x. So that you will have 2 is equal to e power x plus e power minus x by 2 is equal to cos h2. What is cos hx is equal to 2. So cos hx is equal to 2, that's all, is not? So that cos hx, see, cos hx e power x plus e power minus x by 2, so that this is simply 2. So which gives you that e power 2x minus 4x minus 4 e power x plus 1 is equal to 0, since e power minus x is equal to 1 by e power x. So this shows that, so e power x is equal to, e power x is equal to, what you get is 4 plus or minus square root of 16 minus 4 by 2. But 4 minus root 3 or e power x is equal to, because e power x is always positive. So this is 2 plus root 3. Since e power x is a 2. So therefore, by logarithm definition, x is equal to log of 2 plus root 3 to the base e. X is log of 2 plus root 3 plus to the base e. So option 3 itself. So here you have used the definition of concept of e power x, or the definition of e, cos hx. Cos hx is e power x plus e power minus x by 2. So e power x plus e power minus x by 2 is equal to 2. So if you write e power minus x is 1 by e power x, you will get a quadratic in e power x. So that e power x is equal to 2 plus root 3. So x is equal to log of 2 plus root 3 to the base e. 8. If cos hx is equal to secant theta, then tan h square x by 2 is equal to 1 cot theta by 2, 2 tan theta by 2, 3 tan square theta by 2, and 4 cot square theta by 2. Okay? Right. Now the solution is, we know that cos hx in terms of tan hx, cos hx is equal to 1 plus tan h square x by 2 by 1 minus tan h square x by 2. In the beginning, I have given you this formula also. So that implies secant theta is equal to 1 plus tan h square x by 2 by 1 minus tan h h square x by 2 itself. Now use component dividend. Using component dividend, secant theta plus 1 by secant theta minus 1 is equal to adding, so you will get 2 tan square h by x by 2 by component and dividend. So 2 will cancel. So what is this? Is simply 1 plus cos theta by 1 minus cos theta is equal to 1 by tan h square by 2. And that implies 1 plus cos theta is 2 cos square theta by 2. 1 minus cos theta is 2 sin square theta by 2. So this is simply cos square theta by 2 by sin square theta by 2 is equal to 1 by tan h square by 2 means, so if you take ulta sida, we'll get tan h square x by 2 is equal to tan square theta by 2. So therefore tan h square x by 2 is equal to tan square theta by 2. Tan square theta by 2. So which is option number 3, problem number 9. See, if minus pi by 2 less than theta less than plus pi by 2 and sin hx is equal to tan theta, then tan hx is equal to 1 sin theta, 2 cos theta, 3 cosecant theta, and 4 secant theta. And you know that by the formula, standard formulas, cot h square x minus 1 is equal to cosecant h square x, cosecant h square x, which is nothing but, so which is equal to, what you look at is simply cot square theta. Since sin hx is equal to tan theta. Right? So from this what you'll get is cot h square x is equal to 1 plus cot square theta. 1 plus cos square theta. So which is cos square sin square theta plus cos square theta by cos square theta. But this is which is equal to secant square theta, which is secant square theta. So therefore, tan hx, what he asked, tan hx is not sin hx, is tan theta. Cosecant hx means 1 by sin h square x. So that is 1 by tan square theta means cot square theta. It's okay. So cot h square x is equal to 1 plus cot square theta. So cos theta by sin theta is not. This is cos theta by cos square theta by sin square theta. Sin square theta plus cos square theta by sin square theta, which is equal to sin square theta. So therefore, what you get is tan hx, what you asked is 1 by sin square theta. The simplifications, so cot h square, so tan hx is equal to sin theta. Cot h square is equal to, this is 1 by sin square theta. So tan h square is x is equal to sine theta. So tan h is equal to sine theta. So option number 1 from number 10. If x is equal to log of cot of pi by 4 plus theta, then sine hx is equal to number 1 secant 2 theta and 2 tan 2 theta, sorry, sine 2 theta and cosecant 2 theta, 3 tan 2 theta and 4 minus tan 2 theta. Now from this, by hypothesis, e power x is equal to cot pi by 4 plus theta. So this is to 1 minus tan theta by 1 plus tan theta. 1 minus tan theta by 1 plus tan theta. Okay. So therefore, e power minus x, so the e power minus 4 is 1 plus tan theta by 1 minus tan theta, because e power minus x means 1 by e power x. So therefore now sin hx is equal to e power x minus e power minus x by 2. So that is 1 plus tan theta by 1 minus tan theta by 1 plus tan theta whole square, 1 plus tan theta plus 1 plus tan theta by 1 minus tan theta by 2. So which is nothing but 1 minus tan theta by 2. One minus tan theta whole square minus of 1 plus tan theta whole square by 1 minus tan square theta, and this is minus 2 tan theta by 1 minus tan square theta, and this is minus tan 2 theta, minus tan 2 theta. Sin hx is equal to, just calculate e power x and e power minus x and substitute, minus tan 2 theta. So what is the correct option? Right, option number 4. Correction option is option number 4 itself. Now 11th, you can see the range of hx, the range of cos hx is 1 minus infinity plus infinity, 2 minus 1 plus 1, 3 1 to infinity, and 4 open interval 0, 1. So solution, you can have that here, you can use, of course, even though I have given in the list system, function, domain and range, that you can, but anyhow you can see here, you can also, and e power x is always positive for all real x, for all real x. So therefore, cos hx is equal to e power x plus e power minus x by 2, it is greater than or equal to 2 into e power x plus e power minus x, because am is greater than or equal to gm. Arithmetic mean is greater than or equal to geometric mean. So this is nothing but that implies cos hx is always greater than or equal to 1. So therefore range is equal to 1 to infinity, 1 to infinity. So option number 3, see problem number 12 is sin h ix, sin h ix is equal to 1 i sin x 2 sin ix 3. Where is that? Minus I sin x and 4 i sin ix. Okay, just I will give you here, here I explain the relation between the hyperbolic and circular functions. So, number one, we know that sin hx is equal to e power x minus e power minus x by 2. Now, we replace x with ix both sides. Just this is the only relation. Replace I with ix both sides for trigonometric functions converting to hyperbolic functions, or hyperbolic functions converting to trigonometric functions. And atiparavala pramayalni trigonometric pramayalga ki madhya sambandham vachinappudalla corresponding sutralo x badalu minus x pratishepiste saripothundi. X with ix both sides, you will get sin h ix is equal to e power ix minus e power minus ix by 2. And we know that e power I theta means cos theta plus I sin theta. Cos theta plus I sin theta. So this is cos x plus I sin x minus of cos x minus I sin x by 2. So this is, you will get cos x will cancel. So 2 I sin x by 2. So therefore, it is I sin x. Here you have to use the Euler's formula for sin theta and cos theta. So sin theta is e power I theta plus minus e power minus I theta by 2. Cos theta is e power I theta plus e power minus I theta by 2 itself. What is and you can see that is, and I'll give you note, and e power I theta minus e power minus I theta by 2 is equal to sin theta. sine theta. Because e power I theta is cos theta plus I sine theta, and e power minus I theta is cos theta minus I sine theta. Is not. If you replacing theta with I theta, we have sine I theta is equal to e power minus theta minus e power theta by 2. So this is nothing but, can you see what it will be? This minus of e power theta minus e power minus theta by 2. So this is nothing but minus sin h theta. Minus sin h theta. So from the definition of sin theta and Euler's form, we can get sin I theta is minus sin h theta. Because sin I theta is equal to replace theta with I theta. So then you'll get theta is equal to minus e power minus theta minus e power theta by 2, which is minus of e power theta minus e power minus theta by 2. So which is minus sin theta by 2. The rest of the conversion also same. In all that, if you take the trigonometric function, the Euler's form, replace x with ix. Or if you take the hyperbolic function in the definition, you replace x with ix. Problem number 13 is, if cos h2x is equal to 199, then cot hx is equal to 1, 5 by 3 root 11. 2, 5 by 6 root 11. Of course, this is asked in EMACET. 3, 7 by 3 root 11. 4, 10 by 3 root 11. 10 by 3 root 11. So, solution is 199 is equal to cos h2x, and cos h2x you can write it as cos h square x plus sin h square x, and that is cos h square x plus sin h square x by cos h square x minus sin h square x. So, because this is 1, cos h square x minus sin h square x is always a 1. So, if you divide numerator denominator by cos h square x, so that is 1 plus tan h square x by 1 minus tan h square x. So, from this you will get 199 minus 199 tan h square x is equal to 1 plus tan h square x. So that will give you that 200, if you take this, 200 tan h square x is equal to 198. Right. So that is tan h square x is equal to 198 by 200. Which is, if you take 2 outside, 99 by 100. So, therefore, cot h square x is equal to 100 by 99. So, therefore, cot hx is 10 by root 99 means 3 root 11. 3 root 11. So, 10 by 3 root 11 means 4, option number 4 itself. I think 14th problem, if x is equal to log of to the base E into 1 by Y plus square root of 1 plus 1 by Y square, then Y is equal to, then Y is equal to 1 tan HX, 2 cot HX, 3 secant HX, 4 cosecant HX. Now, by hypothesis, e power x is equal to 1 by y plus square root of y square plus 1 by y, which is 1 plus root over y square plus 1 by y itself. That is. Okay. So, therefore, e power minus x, which is 1 by e power x, which is equal to y by square root of 1 plus square root of y square plus 1. But this we can write as y into square root of y square plus 1 minus 1 by y square plus 1 minus 1. That means multiplying numerator denominator with the denominator. That means rationalizing. So, this is root over y square plus 1 minus 1 by y itself. 1 will cancel, y by y will cancel. Root over y square plus 1 minus 1 by y. So, therefore, isn't it? So, what you get is e power x. So, what he asked is, also y value or not? Right. So, sin hx, if you take sin hx is equal to e power x minus e power minus x by 2. So, that is square root of y square plus 1 by plus 1 by y minus square root of y square plus 1 minus 1 by y. So, that is 2 by y. It is 2 by y. So, therefore, y is equal to 2 cosecant hx. Just wait. Is there any by 2? These 2 I will always forget about. The 2. So, 2y, which is equal to 1 by y. So, therefore, y is equal to cosecant hx. Y is equal to 1 by sin x, which is equal to cosecant hx. So, the answer is number 4 option.